I'm going to present the paper that I wrote toward a scalable architecture of small and medium enterprise application using microservice integration. Now, it is a project that I'm doing. It's a PhD project that I'm doing. This is a starting phase. I'm just in proposing, now it is towards integration of small and medium enterprise to microservice architecture. So outline, I'm going to clarify the keywords for this study and the motivation of that related works and approach that I'm going to use to get through it. So first I'm starting by small and medium enterprise application. Why I'm interested on that is that I find that it's my contribution as scientist to work on the themes that really affect us in developing country. So as we those small and medium enterprise are occupying a big number of enterprise that are in the developing countries. And those one, they need to be developed and they need to be updated. So how to do it is to taking care of this application, to increase the applicability of application, yeah, and efficiency. So I am interested on this small and medium application because it has a big size on in our country. And those one, they have a particular problem of infrastructure that they are exposing to IT. You know, with big enterprise, they have everything, they have money, they have infrastructure, and yet the technology is so easy for them. Now, with this small and medium enterprise, them they have limited access to infrastructure, and yet they want to use technology in order to develop the country. And now what I'm going to say also, it is a word scalability. What is that? Is the ability of application to evolve. You have application and you want to expand, you want it to evolve functionally and in capability. So this scalability is important for system to parallel the operations. And this scalability has three dimensions. So application can evolve functionally, or application can evolve by splitting it into different parts. Also, application can be scaled by partitioning data. So that one it is on data level. Another keyword that I'm going to use is microservice architecture. What is this? This is a new approach for developing an application where a single application is divided, is a suite of small services. So each is running in its own process and communicate with lightweight mechanism, such as RESTful services. These applications are built around business capability. So each microservice is like an application itself. So this is the difference between what application have been used before and now the new architecture for making application. First of all, in the first diagram, we have monolithic application where the end user can access application and then that application have one database. With new architecture called microservice architecture, so through load balance, there are different services which are really independent, and each one is running its own database, which could be SQL or not SQL. And with this kind of application, now this architecture is have been proven to be more scalable. As you see now, if application are separated and they are independent, it is one kind of scalability where you can your application is divided. This is the microservice architecture. What is my motivation? My motivation is to link those two things, to link monolithic application and with microservice application, where most of those SME are running monolithic application and where the scalability is so limited. So they can't evolve technically and they can't evolve in capability. So I want to link those two architecture. So at the end, I will have the common architecture for small and medium enterprise, which have their own characteristic of limited infrastructure, and those one they can. I am hoping that after that the architecture will be scalable. So what are the work which have been done through this? There are different approaches which have been proposed to integrate those legacy system. Legacy system are the system which are existing in the enterprise. They have been researched for this for integrating legacy system to service oriented architecture. But it has proven that this service-oriented architecture, it is not more scalable than the new microservices. And my approach is to use now microservices by integrating this microservice with application, SME application. So in related works, what the works which have been done through it is to integrate microservice. Most of the enterprise are migrating. So migration means to move from one architecture to another one. So most of them who are using microservice, they are migrating from a monolithic application to microservice to be used on cloud computing. And my approach, I don't want to migrate. I want to do another sort of integration, which I mix two things like the engineering and wrapping. Those are different methods of integration. So now, the approach that I'm going to use is, I'm going to separate this work into 3-4 phases. So each phase we have the result, and each phase will be tested to for better result. For stage number one, I will acquiring SME application details. This I will be acquiring through re-engineering, because I want to know what exactly those applications, how they are doing. It is like getting data from those applications, and then after that I start to do implementation. So next stage I will start to determine microservice integration patterns. So because the architecture, microservice architecture, it involves many things because of separation of different parts. So if you separate different one application to different application, there are many parts and now should be involved through that. So there are those patterns that I will study on to be API gateway, service discovery, load balance, resource manage. Those are the patterns which are added because we we have taken application and we divided into different phases. So I will analyze this pattern and then determine the best pattern to use. You know, with each pattern, there are different ways to use each the patterns. And I will analyze it to know what's the pattern which can result a more scalable architecture. So then I will make integration architecture model whereby it is a combination of those two. I will do it through software architecture simulator. I'm going to simulate these things in a way that the simulator will take all specification that I have acquired on stage one and then add the pattern that I acquired on stage two and simulate all this in this stage and get the whole models of architecture. Then after that, I want to test through live environment to see the applicability. So through this stage three, it is like the work will be done through that because I will be having the whole architecture model which is ready to be used. But I want also to test through live environment to acquire more knowledge of that model. This is the whole work, this overview of the whole work that I faced through. Those are stage that I was talking about. Getting critical features of SME application, then find the best patterns, then through simulation and through knowing the performance, and I will generate integration architecture model, which I will implement on live environment of SME. So research strategy that I will use, it is through software architecture simulation model. I have found Paradio like a best way, but it is not limited to this. I'm still searching. Maybe I find another architecture experiment model so that I can use. But this time I'll use Paradio because I have found that it is a best way of simulating the architecture of an application. Yeah. Then after that, another research strategy, it is for the phase four, whereby I will go to implement this in live environment. As you have seen, I didn't mention any tools that I will use. Like I will use Java, I will use this, because I will find the best pattern to use. So all patterns are open to me. I can use anything that could be available depending on the result that I want to get. Thank you.